offside action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So the Badgers and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
The running back gets two on the carry.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
Tackle made, the 37-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
First and 10, ball on the 37. Six-yard line. That brings up second and eight.
Nice
run, and he's brought down. Good run by the halfback. That'll be good enough to move the chains.
He took advantage of a powerful effort by his offensive line to turn that into a pretty big run.
From the 47-yard line, first down.
Back five, back five. They got three, nine.
Give to the tailback. Tackle at the 45. A two-yard run by the halfback.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Down around the 45-yard line.
No gain. That'll bring up third and eight.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. Quick out to his receiver, and he's taken down right around the 32-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That brings up second and five.
From the 26-yard line, it's second down. Pushed out of bounds, around the 6-yard line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Nice run there. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 1-yard line. They'll drop him for a loss.
He knew it was a run all the way. He got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
This is the 12th play of this drive. Badgers. he tacks on the extra point. A 12-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Makes it to the 31. He's to the 40. That's a great tackle at the 46. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. And off up the middle, and he's stuck. Down, and they need to get it inside the 44. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended. Now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
It out to about the 21-yard line. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
From their own 18-yard line, second down. Wisconsin is up a score. And they make the stop at the 16-yard line. He wants it all. Almost picked off.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
That brings us fourth and 15.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 45. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. And he hits him hard at the 42-yard line. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 7-0, Badgers. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
He scrambled. He's taken down at about the 41.
Getting the ball to your tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedsters.
Here's the run right. he's got nowhere to go.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
Inside give. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. He gets rid of this one. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Wisconsin is up by four. And he's level at the 26-yard line. That's a that brings us second and nine. From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Again with a carry. Makes it out to about the 40. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. To pick up the first down. He did not get to the first down marker. Nothing there on the keeper. Play of the series. Wisconsin is up four. Runs right for a nice game. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. To his tight end, nothing doing. Here's play number 10 on the drive. And down he goes at the 18.
The offense gets a first down here, and you got to give him some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on the quarterback, especially when they're passing the football, and try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
Nice run to the outside. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 12. This is the 13th play of this drive. tackles him hard at the 3-yard line. They're at the 3. Second down. Throws complete. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. So a 14-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. From their own 32-yard line. First down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. The senior makes the catch. Tackle made at the 21. Don't go anywhere, folks. It looks like we might have a pretty good game on our hands after all. So the Badgers in front by 11.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He'll return it from the 1. Across the 30. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Knocked out of bounds at the 48. I'm not sure what happened, but one of the players is hurt. From their own 48-yard line, first down. He's got an opening. He's tackled around the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10. He He's at the 30, makes it to the 27. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. This one will fall incomplete.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here.
Kirby, we saw this guy go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. He's pretty important to this team, and they're going to have to find a way to work through this win without him.
The kick is up, and he got it. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20, at the 30. And they push him out at about the 47-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Wisconsin up by 8. About 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. It's the tailback. Good outside run there. It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. Brought down at about the 21. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Fake. Plenty of time, and now he's on the move. He takes off. He gets hit out of bounds at the 7. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Wisconsin holds an 8-point advantage. And he carries the ball for a nice game. And this is the 8th play of the drive. They're packed in tight on the line. Touchdown, Badgers. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
So those big guys are going to walk away knowing they had a big hand in that score. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
Tackle at the 27-yard line. From their own 23-yard line, it's third down. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. And he's taken down at the 44-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
He's gobbled up in the backfield. That brings up second and 13. So it's second and 13. Ball on their own 41. Gives it to the back. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. At the 30. And he finally steps out at the 27. First down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. So with one quarter remaining, the Badgers in front, 21-6. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Red, two, orange three.
Scrambling around, and he's sacked.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Third down now. They need to get it to the 17. And he's tackled at the 12-yard line. Outside for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
They're at the 8. Second down. Run left side. He's taken down around the 8-yard line.
The entire defense just collapsed on that run and got penetration into the backfield. Nice job by the safety to clean up the mess.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Red two.
zips it to the tight end.
Touchdown, Wisconsin.
And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 56-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense really stepped up to force that 3-and-out on the last drive. They'll bring him down around the 27-yard line. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. From their own 27-yard line, third down. He's to the 40, gets it out to the wide out, and he's got the first. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. And down he goes, right around the 42-yard line. From the 30-yard line, second down. He's at the 20. There's a strike complete. And forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Now he's scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure. So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. And he hits him hard at the 14.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. The 7-yard line.
That's good for the game of 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion.
Kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
So the offense will take over with pretty good field position.
The onside kick just wasn't successful there. The kicker really didn't give his guys a chance to make a play.
Well, they had a lot of success on their last possession, and now they're going to start this one off with excellent field position.
It's hard to ask your defense to come out and make a stop when they're already backed up this far within their own end zone.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 25-yard line. Room around the corner.
He's into the open field.
He's brought down to the open field.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Gets to about the 5-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
On the ground, left side. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Offense.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. From the 20-yard line, second down. Just over a minute left. Up the middle for a nice gain. His way out to about the 6. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be delivered. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Wisconsin's team right now aware that they are a team. Hey, their star didn't shine today. Everybody else picked up the pace, though.
I think we all came in expecting to see that star player really shine. And the fact that they didn't have a great game from him and still won the football game, boy, I walked away from this game as a viewer just thinking even that much more about this team than maybe what I thought prior to the football game.